Hello everybody, how are you doing? I am Miss Noha Al Ahmad. I will teach you nutrition for grade 10, term 3 of the year 2019-2020. In this term, we will talk about the role of carbohydrates. Of course, before talking about the role of carbs and its importance, we should know how to classify carbohydrates or how carbohydrates are classified. Carbohydrates are classified into two groups, simple and complex one. In simple carbohydrates, we can find monosaccharides and disaccharides. From its name, monosaccharide, it means it is composed only of one molecule. Disaccharide, it's composed of two molecules. In complex carbohydrates, we can find polysaccharides. Also from its name, poly, it means like we have three molecules or more than three molecules. Examples for monosaccharide, glucose, fructose, and galactose. Disaccharide, we have maltose, lactose, and sucrose. Polysaccharide, we have starch, fibers, glycogen. We'll talk about each one and briefly, but before we have to know what are saccharides. Saccharides are considered to be the building block of carbohydrates or the simplest form of carbohydrates. Saccharides are considered to be organic molecule. Why it is organic molecule? Because it is composed of carbon atom, hydrogen atom, and oxygen atom. Regarding its structure or unique structure for each type of saccharide, since we have more than one type of saccharide. For example, as we see, saccharides can be glucose, galactose, and fructose. If you want to take a look, those are considered to be monosaccharide. Monosaccharide, it means that it is composed only of one type of saccharides. So, again, saccharides are the building block of carbohydrates or the simplest form of carbohydrates, and they are considered to be the main source of energy inside our body, since the simplest form of carbohydrates can be absorbed by our body and then it can generate energy for our daily activity. If you want to think about carbohydrates, the first thing we will think about it is the starchy food like bread, pasta, potato, or the sweet things like chocolate, cake, cookies. Those are carbohydrates. The main difference of it, some of them are simple, others are complex. So, saccharides are molecules. They are composed of carbon, hydrogen, and oxygen. Monosaccharide, only one saccharide, like glucose, galactose, and fructose. Disaccharide, we have two molecules of saccharides that are binded together. Again, monosaccharides are the simplest sugar, like glucose, or the most common name for monosaccharide, glucose. Glucose is the simplest sugar and it refers to blood sugar, and as we know that the blood sugar, it ranges between 80 to 120. Fructose is another type of monosaccharide, and we can find it in fruits. So fructose, fruits. The third type of monosaccharides called galactose. Galactose is a type of monosaccharide that's found in milk. Those monosaccharides, they differ in their structure and they are considered to be the simplest form of carbohydrates. Since the structure of glucose, as we see, that the shape of it is considered as a single ring, and it is mainly composed of carbon, hydrogen, and oxygen. That's why it is a type of organic molecule. We have also fructose and galactose, and they have ring shape also. This is the common thing between the three monosaccharides, and also they can generate energy for our body. Second thing is disaccharide. Disaccharide, they are sugar. Also, they are considered to be simple sugar, and they are the result of combination of two monosaccharides. Example of them: maltose, sucrose, and lactose. In this figure, we can see two monosaccharides that are bounded together to form a molecule of disaccharide. During dehydration reaction, H2O water is removed, and it will be a product of combination between two monosaccharides to form a certain type of disaccharide. Here we have this equation. In this equation, we have a monosaccharide. In the hydration reaction, as we said together, the two monosaccharides will bind together as reactants, where in the product we will find H2O water is removed and disaccharide is formed by a bond between two monosaccharide, which is called the glycosidic linkage. So again, we can say that the combination of molecules or the combination of monosaccharide by removing water is called dehydration reaction or dehydration synthesis, since we are forming a disaccharide by combining two monosaccharides together. It depends on the types of monosaccharide that are binded together. So if we have glucose plus glucose, if we are combining two glucose together, we will get maltose. If we are combining glucose with fructose, the result will be sucrose. If we are combining glucose with galactose, the result will be lactose. This is so much important. You have to know how we are forming the disaccharide, and you should know also each molecule is formed of unique type of or unique types of monosaccharides. Here we can find sucrose, glucose and fructose, lactose, galactose and glucose, maltose, glucose plus glucose. If you want to take a look, you can find that each one of them monosaccharide, it has its own shape, which is unique, and it is different from the others. Finally, polysaccharide, it is the formation of carbohydrates by combining more than three saccharides together. An example of them is starch and cellulose are considered to be carbohydrates, and we can find them in starchy foods such as grains, rice, tubers like potato, some type of starchy vegetable, carrot for example, legumes, beans. Those starchy foods they are not easily dissolved in water. They should be cooked to release the starch from them, and then it will be easy for our body to digest them into simple sugar, and then this simple sugar will be absorbed as a source of energy. The important thing about polysaccharides that it contains a lot of fibers. The fibers will help in digestion since we do not have the enzymes to digest the fibers. It will provide our digestive system with roughage, which is a fibrous material that will help in the passage of food through the gut. So it will eliminate the excess waste through our digestive tract. So for us, it is too much important to choose our source of carbohydrates, if it is simple or if it is complex. As a summary, classification of carbohydrates, we have monosaccharide, disaccharide, and polysaccharide. In monosaccharide, we have three types: fructose, glucose, and galactose. Disaccharide, we also have three types: sucrose, maltose, and lactose. Here we should know that they are a result from a dehydration reaction or dehydration synthesis of two monosaccharides together. And also we have to know each type of disaccharide is composed of two unique types of monosaccharide. Last thing to know that polysaccharides are composed of more than three molecules or more of monosaccharide. And for polysaccharide, the common type of them are called starch. And all of them at the end, like disaccharide and polysaccharide, they have to be digested into simple sugar like monosaccharide, and mainly it will provide our body with the energy. In the second part of our video, we will talk about the sources of carbohydrates.